Thank you. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the stream. It is Thursday, May 12th, 2016, 3 p.m. Central Time here in Chicago. Hope you guys are all doing well. Let me go ahead and post on Twitter, let everyone know that we are now live. Okay, so today, what are we doing? We're continuing to work on this wire thing. Now, I've got a system set. Hey, Praetorian, 1978, Flint Steel 7. Welcome back. So, Right, so I have an idea of how, because the tricky thing, so what I did was actually ended up organizing this. This used to be called interlockable line end, and that actually just got really freaking messy because these things don't actually go on interlockables. They can also, see that piece is not an interlockable, right? So it's just a line end. Hey, NCATM, hello. Welcome back. So there's these line ends, and then they can be, you know, they can be on an interlockable. So now what I do, there's sort of a, I can kind of play with some of, now where it gets tricky is that these can be, so what you have is I have kind of different groups. So an interlockable line end, it can be on an interlockable or not. In this case, it's not. Or I can have it be a provider or a receiver. So a provider means that it's sending the signal. A receiver means that it's getting it. Now you only have, we're only talking about it in the context of two pieces connecting. So in this case, you have, we're looking at this one. So now this one is always going to be the provider because it's actually not on an interlockable. So if it's not on an interlockable, that means it's set. But if it's checked as a provider, it's going to be provider for life. Because this doesn't make sense for this to receive electricity in here. On the other hand, if it's on an interlockable, it can become a receiver or a provider depending on which one's which. So what happens is if one of them becomes the receiver, what it does is it tells the other ones to... become a provider. So this is setting up the next chain. I'm gonna have another how is everyone doing today? So pretty cool news. I will be at E3 this year. Actually, it's going to be... Yeah, so I'm going to be at E3. The game will be... Manifold Garden will be playable there, which is very, very exciting. And what else? I'm actually going to be hitting up Indie PopCon, which is right after. Hey, Skivernat! Hello! I think that this is the first time I'm seeing you here. So it's going to be kind of crazy. I'm going to be flying from Chicago to LA, doing E3, which is super exhausting. And then right after that, like, E3 ends, I go straight to the airport, take a red eye to Indianapolis. So I think the flight will be at like 11 p.m. LA, time. I get, arrive in Indianapolis 6 in the morning, head straight to the convention center. Well, maybe I'll get breakfast. No, I should get breakfast and then set up and then do another full day. So it's just going to be like, it's going to be 3 days. Is E3 3 days? Yeah, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Yeah, it's going to be 3 days of E3 and then Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then 3 days of Indie PopCon. So it's going to be pretty brutal. But Indie PopCon's really nice. It's a very small event, so it's not as intense. And the nice thing is actually, so like with E3, it's just press. You just press. Like every half hour, you're talking to different press. And that's cool. But Indie PopCon, so there's not a whole lot of press. But what's really cool is you end up actually getting to talk to players and they don't feel like they're super rushed for time. One thing that is very neat is I've been going to Indie PopCon since the very, very beginning. So that was the first one, that was in 2015, 2014. And last year I went, and it's like, it's small enough that people actually remember me from previous years. And they're like, oh man, I've seen the game grow so much and I recognize people. That usually almost never happens. So that's pretty exciting. Yeah, so Major Idea, in fact, was right. I am going to be at E3, and that's a huge opportunity. It really is a fantastic opportunity. So I'm super excited. So June is going to be a lot of traveling, and I got my Steamworks account. So I got my Steam developer account. I kind of set that up, sort of waiting for them to verify my tax information and all that. But hopefully I should be setting up a Steam store page soon so everybody can start adding that to their wish list, which I think is going to be very exciting. This is called... So we're going to have another one, which is called... You're going a little overboard with the naming of the functions here, but I saw Indie Mega Booth opened up PAX Prime. But I don't know if I'll do that. I mean, it's just so expensive. Like, I was even looking at, IndieCade's deadline is coming up May 15th for the regular submission. And it's pretty expensive. It's like $150 to submit. And I'm thinking, okay, it's $150 to submit. Flight to LA is going to be like $300. It's like $400, $500. You know, maybe I can, I think I know enough people in LA at this point, I can probably stay with a friend. But it's time away from development, it's just like, it's $150, I don't even know if I'll get in. Whereas when I work with Sony, like, and you gotta bring your own computer and all that. Whereas when you work with Sony, like they just set up the game for you. It's on like this big TV. It's running on a dev kit, so it's running very well. I just show up. They handle the takedown, the setup. It's you know, I don't need to pay them to apply for that. So I don't know, you know. Yeah, is anyone planning on hitting up events? So yeah, and PAX Prime is super expensive. I don't know. Showing the game is just very, very expensive, and I'm not... Okay, so this is when one line end is set as the so is provider equals to false, and then opposite line end dot is provider no, opposite line end dot get component. You know what? Actually. Hey LaPraz96, there is going to be level design, but I need to get coding done before I work on. I mean, there's basically everything left to do. The issue here is that I can't continue with more level design until I get coding done. So yeah, because right now I don't have a programmer, so I gotta do everything. So no, they are based in Chicago, so they will be working remotely because I work from home. But one of the things I want to do moving forward is actually have him come down and work in person with me twice a month. I think that would be very, very helpful. I think things didn't work out with the last programmer. There were some communication issues, and it just, yeah, I don't want to go too much into detail, but I think there were a lot of, I think, expectations of work that weren't met. So I think I want to have them in person. You know, so we can communicate and just kind of like, you know, being able to have them see the game and being like, hey, you know, I think there is a lag when you enter the left when you're playing with the controller. So, okay, so see what happens is when we get the if the other line is on an interlockable. Yeah, it doesn't solve that, but I think it can help. And I think there were just like there were some stuff that was time dependent and it sort of wasn't being met, but yeah, it's not anyway, you know, you live and learn. It's definitely a hard part, but the nice thing is that these issues are, that everybody deals with these issues. It looks good. So try to. Bring in this comment over here. Line ends need to connect. Hey, Smoke Lore, how's it going? Welcome to the Nerd Fest. Today we are programming. Doing more, but I figured out I kind of got all the logic set up. If the provider line end is lit up, oh, I think I need to remove it from the unfilled. Actually, I'm just going to go ahead and delete the interlockable line end so we're not being confused. Yeah, I actually do that mostly because I'm really bad at stuff, so I try to make sure to I try to do it. I probably overcomment, but for me that's honestly a l much better than undercommenting. Where is the donate button? There is no donate button. Have I played any Overwatch? No, I have not played any Overwatch. I've been too busy with this. There is a. Should I set up a donate button? I don't know. I haven't. I kind of just want people to add the game to their wish list once that's available. Hey, Biddy Joe 45. Yes. Downloading projects here is good. Yeah, Unity's got plenty. Right, so what are we talking about? So this is so yeah, so one thing I need to do here is remove the other line and then have you I played any good games recently, other than Dark Souls? I really enjoyed Project High Rise. Technically, I haven't played Dark Souls. I've been playing Bloodborne. Renty, hello. By the way, if you guys are enjoying this stream, if you're new, you should definitely follow. Okay, so Project High Rise is pretty good. Remove other line end from delegate. I've mostly been studying the Souls game, like. Reading about them, watching them, I kind of watched this like 2 hour long video last night that analyzed Bloodborne, which is very interesting. So this dot on filled, I think. So I need to remove this, right? For those of you that are familiar with delegates, since I added that here, I need to take it away. Is that correct? right? Because this is, so what's happening is when they connect, we're adding it to the delicate. So when this one gets filled, the other one gets lit up. And when the other one is emptied, this one gets emptied. And I think what I need to do is take that out of, hey, beep to bleep, what's up? How's it going? So, for why most people feel like the first Dark Souls has by far the best architecture. The thing is, I like the art style, the like gothic one in Bloodborne a lot. Not a huge fan of like, although some people like the generic fantasy. I think it's just, I think that's got like a much better sort of connection. I love how the chat is basically like a Dark Souls forum. So what I do is I manually set. So the way it has to be set up on the lines is there's always two pairs of interlockables and then there's one line mesh in between. Let's see if this works. Oh, come on. It's not lighting up. Oh, the reason for that is because I didn't actually connect them. Ah, stupid. It's this one's. I didn't actually connect them up. So actually, you know what? This would be a good time to rename these. Line mesh one. Line mesh two, line mesh three. So it's not the most generic system that I've written, but it's sort of like, I'm not, it's like, I'm also not trying to make the most generic wire system, right? It's just enough that I, for my game. So one, let's see. One, two, three, four, five. Demon Souls. Yes. Have I tried to replicate the Gothic architecture style in the Manifold Garden on a structural level, at least, you know, without the incredibly... I do. I do sort of have that in some of the places. Not quite Gothic. The thing is, it needs, like, the pointy tops to really feel Gothic, and I'm not sure if I have that, but Okay, so this is good. This is good. Now let's see if this connects. It's more a mix of like prayer, American prairie, and oh, sick. Yes. Yes. So let's see. This should now light up. Okay. Okay. So there we go. Okay, so there we're having a problem, right? Because it's not No, I can't do pointing tops because then that would have to require the thing to be at an angle, which I don't have. I think I'm pretty sure it's just not connected properly. So, it's very exciting. Right, so there is kind of a pain here where I have to like manually set them, but these are not, I'm not doing them so often that so I don't think that's a huge, I don't think I have to worry about it too much. Like I do have to, you can see I gotta like manually put in the other opposite, kind of like do this, but I think it's not I do it infrequently enough that it's not a major issue for this. Do I have any formal training in graphic design architecture, or do you just go by what looks in? I almost went to architecture school. I don't have formal training in the sense I didn't go to school for that. But I also don't just go by what feels right. Like I did work in at a really big ad agency. I worked at Leo Burnett here in Chicago for about 7 months when I had just graduated from college. So I wasn't in the creative department, but I did end up getting one ad made. I made a spec ad, so I like I studied a lot with the kind of designers there, right? Like every day I'd go home and I make spec ads and I bring it in and I'd show them. So there's no formal training in the sense I didn't go to school, I didn't get a degree, but I just, through work, I kind of was open to talking to people about it and kind of learned in those cases. So that's my training. So it's not, I'm not just kind of going by purely gut feeling, like I have studied up on it. Okay, so for some reason we're not lighting up this guy. Okay, so yeah, I think it's a really good way to learn. Hey, Zeus Monolith. It's been a while. Yeah, I really think that's a great way to learn. It's harder, and I think people don't. They are. No, so Smoke Lord, they are, right? But right now, I just want to kind of get the basic system working. It's like there's kind of different ways of optimizing it, and you know, if I'm doing a lot, but right now I'm just sort of trying to get the basic logic set up for now. So yeah, I think that's the thing is, you know, I remember, so I worked in advertising for about 7 months there, and I was not in the creative department. I was in this position where I was basically sending out emails, but I wanted to be in the creative department at the time. And so, like I said, I worked on these spec ads. So I went in on the weekends, worked every day. Like I'd go home every day and just like work until midnight trying to make fake ads. But the thing is, the the recruiter had a really still like wouldn't give me a chance. And I think this was because what happens is they sometimes people's okay, so that's obviously not being said as the provider. Like, they don't want to take chances on you if you have, like, the way advertising works is you're supposed to go to portfolio school, which is like 2 years, and you just do Photoshop every day, and they give you, like, it's all these old ad guys, and they give you campaigns, fake campaigns to work on, and by the end of 2 years, you have a portfolio of a bunch of spec ads. But it's like, if you've been making fake ads for 2 years, you should have 10 good ones. And the idea, but, like, you know, they have student advertising competitions, which you only qualify for if you're a student at an ad school, right? But that means that it's kind of grandfathered in, like, people only, the recruiters are trained to get people from advertising schools who've won the advertising student awards and not people from outside of that system. In a way, perhaps that might be similar to games. I think games is a little bit better because you can just be like, show me what you've got. The problem comes where this is the line to end is correct, right? Yeah, I think the problem becomes you know what it is, we didn't set them as being on an interlockable, so it wasn't getting called. So the issue, and then the thing is, if the recruiter hires someone from that system and they turn out not to be a good hire, the recruiter can just be like, well, you know, I did everything right. Like, look, they went to this good school. They won all these advertising awards. I don't know why he's not a good... Like, I did everything right. I covered my ass. But if they take a chance on someone outside the system and they turn out to be a bad hire, it's like, you know, well, why didn't you just follow the protocol? So that was very frustrating, being at a very large company, right? And Burnett is like 1,000... Like, Burnett US... is 1,000 people, and that is, I mean, that's the headquarter, but there's like, they have 100 offices around the world, so. Myself a muffin. You, Varenti wanted to go into advertising but chose IT. How are you liking it? I mean, advertising is cool except for kind of what the job has you doing, right? Which is like people talk about how marketing is terrible. And marketing is only terrible when you're not, when you don't believe in what the thing you're selling, right? Because with advertising, it's like, you know, if Burger King pays me more, then I like Burger King. Whereas if McDonald pays me more, then I like McDonald. Whereas with marketing this game, it doesn't feel like that because I really do believe in this project. By the way, did anyone know if I'm going to get banned for eating on Twitch? I hope not. I mean, it's not really... Whoa, wait! Praetorian, you worked at you're a Burnetter as well. Oh, that's very cool in the Czech Republic. Oh, that is so cool. You know, did I tell you? Did I ever show you what I worked on? It's actually pretty funny. Yeah, the agency environment. It's rough. It's funny because I remember I met this woman. She was also on the Always account. They also worked on, this is the only ad I ever made during my time in advertising. It is the first feminine hygiene ad to ever have blood in it. So there's that. Like, it's pretty funny. Kerfuffle has had a really funny headline. Is it still there? The link's not dead. Oh no. Well, you can still see the title. Oh, this is funny. Jezebel. In historic moment, feminine hygiene ad shows blood. Oh shit, that was in 2011. Damn, that was a long time ago. It's funny because I remember there's one creative director, she was like, the only reason why I've lasted so long in advertising is because I never thought of myself as an artist, and I had this artist who thought of every ad he made as an art, and he burned out after 6 months, and I was like, he burned out after a year or something, and I was like, ugh. When she first told me that, I was like, what a loser. And I lasted 7 months, so... Oh man, Praetorian, that was cool. What, yes, I know, like, you know, the last programmer, they were working, I don't want to go into that, but I was, yeah, I was at the agency until midnight quite often. But yes, it was a very useful experience, and I learned a lot about marketing. So like, that's one thing that I'm very happy with. It's like, My attitude there was, I would, even if I don't get a job at the agency, I want to make sure I walk away. You know, I was like, oh, I walk away being able to start my own agency. And that's not, I think that's a really big, because I think a lot of it also comes down to connections. But it's still a big, I definitely learned a tremendous amount. So I think it's important to kind of learn a lot about, did I know I can middle click? I do know that, yes. I just don't really use it. I think I've seen that feminine hygiene app before, probably. How do I think marketing experience affects you? I mean, you just gotta treat marketing important, right? And the thing is, it's like, what people... I don't know, it's a sort of a... It's a big topic, for sure. But, like, your game, I have to want to buy your game. Like, there's gotta be something magical. And I think I remember, like, when I first saw the Inception trailer... I was like, holy shit, I've got to see this, right? And I think I wanted to try to capture that with what this game is. Yeah, a lot of money up front. Okay, so I think this should all be working. So let's try this. We should open up the door. I mean, you can learn advertising, you can still, I would, you know, as tough of an environment as it was, I would recommend, like, working at an agency for a bit. Not too long, you have to be careful, because people burn out a lot, and people change jobs all the freaking time. The thing with working at an agency, if you work at one agency, you'll end up meeting people, you'll end up knowing people at all the different agencies. Hey, occurs Zebra 52. Hello. Wow, Zeus Monolith, thank you. So like, what's interesting there, what the hell was I talking about? Something, I was talking about advertising or something, but I don't remember. Oh, right, yeah, so you end up every know, because people, what happens is people will, like, there'll be an art director at one place, and then they'll get a job at somewhere else, and then be a, you know, then they'll be like associate art director, and then like, then they'll move to another agency and become like adjunct creative director. But also your reputation is really important. It's mainly in this level, but might get introduced later. So, okay, so this is where things get a little bit tricky now. So first we need to actually make sure that this piece turns off when we switch. How much will this game be when it comes out? Haven't announced yet. It will be reasonably priced. Did I remove the balance? I don't think I've done anything. I haven't done anything with the balance. I haven't done anything to touch the actual code itself for the interlock. It's all just been... Okay, good. Now what I want to do is... okay, so see, that's... Aha. You see, this is an issue now, right? Because what's going on here is that this isn't lighting up. Yes, because... So here's the problem, which is I know very well, is that it still thinks that... Why is it not, isn't the internal deactivation that? Gotta get that, gotta upgrade that console. Okay, what the hell is going on? So it's not turning off, because this should be, I thought internal deactivate. Is filled is false, then what it does is it should tell an update. Okay, so we need to figure out how to turn off the line. That's the tricky thing now. How the hell do I turn this off? Right, so I believe what happens is you have this delegate, and when it's called, when it's on filled, on emptied, it's called. So that makes it an on unfilled. So is filled. Is this? Okay, so it still thinks it's filled. Don't Starve is awesome. I remember... Hey, Garrett Polk, how's it going? Boombox. No idea what that is. Boomblox? Oh, yes. By the way, you guys know Clay also streams. Okay, I'm not sure why it's thinking that it's off. Okay, for some reason. No, wait. This is the. I had that locked by accident. So this is definitely. Is filled is off. And it's not, for some reason, it's not calling its next one. Why am I not telling the next line to. Why am I not telling the next line? To turn off, that is the question. Because what should happen? Hey, oh, reddit.com Unity tutorials. I didn't know that. Yeah, Clay is kind of got that indie game down. So, right, like when this thing exits. The provider, it should be telling this one. Oh, interesting. So doesn't this so bool and fill if line.active is false, then in the update it will. Okay. Hold on. All right. Computer shaders, which are awesome. Hey guys, yeah, I'm glad CurzZebra52, glad that's helpful. Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out. I'm gonna print out and make sure that that's called. It's weird. It feels like I'm not sure why the next ones here are not getting turned off. Little bit confused here. Because they're getting turned on, they should be getting turned off as well. Hey, Clake69, how's it going? All right, let's see here. So, we have that lit up. Let's see there. We should get this to fall down. Hey, Starlight Skies! Welcome. So glad you could make it. How'd your stream go yesterday? Okay, so line and on and fill the internal is called. So this is called the deactivate is being called. Okay, here we go. All right, my stream was amazing, even though 3D modeling can be boring. You think 3D modeling is boring, you should try programming. So, it's 40 minute pass and no freight train. Oh, there's a train. Hey, great amalgamation. Oh, it's been a while. It's been forever. How's it going? Okay, we're trying to figure out how the hell is going on here. Why is this not lighting up? Oh, why is this not getting turned off? That's the crazy thing here. Yes. Yeah, you guys should check out so Starlight Skies is another developer here in the Midwest. And she streams. She does streaming. So you guys should follow her channel. If you guys are looking for other devs to follow, definitely recommend her channel. Okay, so what's my mind is mostly just kind of focusing on this. Praetorian. What's a good The Double? That's by Richard Ayoade has that art style. What the hell is going on here? This is so fucking weird. I think it's because it's not because see what this is what happens, right? So we have the chainable. We deactivate. The double, yeah, that one has a similar tone. That's definitely the closest one I can think of. So it's internal deactivate, it's on unfilled. Morris Moss, yes. Okay, so it's on unfilled. Are we adding things to on unfilled? Like, we're not adding this to the delegate. Where the hell is this happening? Request deactivate. Okay, so we have the internal deactivate. God, what the hell is happening? Okay, let me try this one more time. Unity likes taking breaks, yes. Unity likes taking breaks very, very often. So. I mentioned how much I don't like programming? Let's try this. I just needed to make my console clear on play. Programming is like solving a puzzle in The Witness. Yes, except once you solve a programming puzzle, there is a reason for it. No, I'm kidding. The Witness is great. I do like it. Yeah, obviously I think a lot about it, but not a game without flaws. But you know, just in case Jonathan Blow is watching, I do really, really. Why? I am always getting calls at this hour. I don't know what the deal is. Yes. Okay, so this is totally getting turned off, and you can see it is getting cold. It's the line 3 deactivate unfilled internal. Okay, so I think the problem is that it's not. I think I know what the issue is. I think so. Here, it's not. It's the line 3 internal deactivate is getting called, but the on unfilled, no one's getting added to that. Like, when the hell do things get added to the delegate so that they know to turn themselves off? Aha. 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 I've got it. Have got it. Ah, I think it's this. Lair fucker. Ah, sorry. Why is it on? Why is there on emptied and on unfilled? Who wrote this code? Because it should be on emptied, I think. It's hey, Enhypnion, welcome. So basically, there's like a delegate. It's a delegate is like you yell Lapras 96. It's like you're like, okay, I don't care what you do, and it's basically like when you yell, I'm done. I drink my coffee. So it's basically like, okay, Starlight Skies, I'll see you later. Enhypnion, by the way, welcome. By the way, if you're enjoying the stream, you should definitely follow the channel. So it's like Lapras96, you yell, I'm done, and I drink coffee. So whenever I hear you yell, I'm done, I drink my coffee. And I think so that's like the signal. So basically it's like that's what the delegate is. It's like when this thing on emptied is called, that's what gets like so let me see the code. So right here, what we're saying is other line on emptied is like when the other one is emptied, this one needs to get internal deactivated. Oh, it looks like because it's. I just don't understand, but it's like there's like. Yeah, I think there's one is unfilled. And I don't know why it's being called. I think it should just be on emptied. Hey, Tahoe Biker, hello. So that's sort of why I think that's what's happening here. I don't know if they're redundant. There might have been a reason for that, but that should have been commented. I drink your milkshake. Speaking of drinking milkshake, I am quite interested in what in that new movie that Paul Dano. Dono is in. What is it? Swiss Army Man. Yes. See, I knew it. That's what, why is it unemptied and not unfilled? I don't understand. There's probably a reason for it, but it should have been commented. Okay, hold on a second now. No, it's not going to be a PS4 exclusive. It will be on PC and PS4, but I like having a, I mean, I like gaming on the couch, so I like having the console, but you know, it's up to you really. Okay, now I'm wondering why this guy isn't getting turned off. So we're super close, and it's like this guy needs to get. Line 5 needs to get called. Line 10 deactivate. Close. Will it be on Wii and Xbox? Probably not Wii. Hey, CP Beast, welcome. Yes, the creative channel is very good. By the way, if anybody is new and you're enjoying the stream, you should definitely follow. I think you're looking for an intro. Lamb. Hey, and Hypnion. Thank you for the follow. Also, Shinga Mix C2, K Stress 71, and Matty Yal C 200F. I'm not sure why I'm not hearing any of those. Oh, right, because I have my audio set up. Hey, Night Changer, thank you for the follow. Sorry guys, I wasn't getting the notifications because I will there be an open beta? Maggot 2, Mage 2, thank you for the follow. Not an open one, but I am gonna start one through itch.io starting next week. So we've got all of this. Okay, now this is happening. We are seeing this get. I think that was like a tricky thing, but now what I'm a little bit confused about is why. So this guy's next. Hey, Bassy Dev, thank you for the follow. I'm also on Twitter, if you guys are on that platform. Okay, so we've got the 5, which it knows it's the end, right? And we know that this currently, this is line end 4, it is a provider. Line N 5 is not. So what our code here is saying is that when it exits, if I am the provider and the other guy is line end dot other line end, right, that's just that, okay. Now, if it is the next one, which in this case it is, it's going to start the internal deactivate. Now, the internal deactivate, does it add? Why can't I click on this? Okay, it should. Again, I don't understand. I might have to rewrite this internal deactivate so that I actually understand what the hell is happening. Aha. So I think this is where it's happening. Okay, wait, I have an idea. I know what I'm gonna test. Why? What does the deactivate from itch.io? Itch.io is like a sort of a different. It's sort of an alternative to Steam. Not, I mean, not really. Steam is still pretty much the go-to, but I think itch.io is sort of like a very indie-friendly platform, and I think it's great to have more options in the ecosystem. Yeah, I know. So what's happening is that this assumes, so I think this is the key, right? So at the beginning, what it is at the start, it takes, if the next one is a null, when you are filled up, it adds the next one to be activated when you're filled. But the problem is that here in this case, it's the next one that's to be emptied. So like it's, I think we had some like I think this was working when we had kind of an assumption of what is wait, what? Wait a minute, wait a fucking minute. Wait, I'm so confused. Oh, because it would empty from the door. I think it's some of this like previous. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna light up, and if I take off the box, I'm gonna wondering how that lights up. Cookies all the way down. Oh man, it's coffee time. I think we're gonna have to have some coffee soon. It's time. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna light this up. And you can see this is gonna light up this chain. Now what I should see when I connect it, okay. Yeah. So see, this is where I'm getting confused. The Okay, this unemptied causes previous dot internal to deact to. So shouldn't previous dot handle deactivating this previous next? Oh, wait, you're right. That's fucking. Wait, hold on a second. God damn. Let me. Okay. Yeah, okay, so right, so like let's see here. Right, so it's the previous one. So in this case, okay, so it when it fills, the next one is activated, and when it's emptied, the previous one is deactivated. So it should be like the next one is this. This one doesn't have a previous because it's at the end. Ah, no. So, right, so it needs the previous, its previous is. Oh, I see. I know what the issue is. Ah, YOLO swag 420, my tier. We are gonna go ahead and ban you. No. I know what's happening, Smoke Lord. It's because so this one's got this is the previous line for this. And I think what's happening is when we connected, we make. No, wait, what? This is the next one. No, so it makes the previous one. It's the previous internal activate. Unemptied. Oh, yeah, wait a minute. It should make the previous. So that is the previous. No, see, that is the next. That is the next. When it's connected, it makes this one the previous. So if we have two lines when two is emptied. Aaron Easley. Well, thank you for the host, Aaron. Thank you so much. Really, really appreciate it. It should have previous. So, like, what happens is when it's emptied. So if I have two and one is. So one is the previous of two. When two is emptied, one is get internal deactivated. I don't understand. Wait, shouldn't it be next one? Like. I'm so fucking confused. Like, why isn't it? Okay, guys, Aaron does. Aaron is another creative streamer here on Twitch. Has like a super chill channel if you guys like painting. It's very different from game dev, but it's super chill. Yes, so the code can't handle bi-directional deactivation. We're trying to set up bi-directional deactivation, and that's what's causing all of the problems. Hey, King Dragon 2713. Hello. Welcome. Goddamn, this is. Okay, we're gonna take a break. Yeah, no, we need to know from which direction we're deactivating from. So I'm gonna go make some coffee. Well, it should, because it should know if it's. No. So here's Smoke Lord. Here's where it gets interesting. So The bidirectional stuff only happens on the bidirectional stuff only happens on the lines with the interlock bolt. This is always single directional. This will always get deactivated this way. You know what I mean? Because like this is never going to, this is always a receiver, and not a provider. But I do need some coffee. It's 4:22, so I think hopefully I've explained the conundrum efficiently. But all right, today we'll be checking out Stumptown, which is from Portland. Universal time for coffee. Oh man, the stream delay is I am trying to follow as much as I can though. It's actually not too bad. It's a Stumptown opened a small cafe with I don't know if you guys can read that, with a 5 kilo coffee roaster on a little known street in Southeast Portland, Oregon, Division Street. Chocolate red fruit composed. Very cool. Let's see. Heard great things about Stumptown. Oh, okay. Let's see this. To measure anything, I just sort of eyeball it. It smells very good. Universal time for coffee. That is it. At some point, I should probably clean the grinder. Right, now I gotta get a spatula and stir this in. Pencil grinder would be less useful. Pencil sharpener. To go the last of your cold brew batch this morning. I need to learn how to cold brew. Right, and then I guess we just go ahead and fill this up. Oh, yeah. While I'm here, I want to talk about my mystery garden. Put coffee grounds in some stockings or some other easy filter. Put in a mason jar full of water. Put it in the fridge for 48 hours. Oh, interesting. So anyway, this is sort of this mystery plant that I've been growing. I wonder if Twitch allows for gardening, but I think it's starting to get big enough that it doesn't. By the way, does anybody know what these are called? Can I just plant them in the I know I need to transfer it to this pot, because it's starting to get too big for this. But yeah, I hope it's not something illegal, because I actually don't know what it is. Noah 13. I feel like everyone I know owns that French press cup. Well, it's the most popular option on Amazon. Enhancing game dev and coffee making skills at the same time. Yeah, the two really go together very well. So I think what's happening is that it's not. Although I'm confused because why is you know what? Let's take a look at this guy. So this is our script for. Whoa. What kind of cubes will they grow? I've had these for months. Yeah. Whatever they are, they don't grow super quickly. Okay, so. When I put the box on, it's growing. Okay, so it requests activate. I guess what I'm confused about is shouldn't this, so like you see I've got this line, there's a line mesh, right? This is like the one next to it. When I turn on this, it requests it to activate, right? It activates a line, which is taking the next line and it's requesting it to activate. When I remove it, it requests it to deactivate. Now see, this is all inside line display here. Little traditional espresso makers, you add water to the bottom. Did you drink too much coffee? I can taste colors. How do you use the burner? Wait. There's a single burner for espresso. I used to use it for hookah coals and I've grown out of it into the espresso. What? Oh, this is very cool. Oh. X90Z75EK. Hello, by the way. Welcome to the Clark Tank. It's not my channel. So I don't understand how. So what I'm confused about is why in the chainable it's unempty. Wait. So wait. Hold on. Let's go back to line display. Let's go back to this line display. So request, so the we know our activator button, it's calling request activate and request deactivate. Okay, and that's actually inside chainable. So it's request activate and I'm like, oh, okay, so it is. What the fuck? Okay. So when it's requesting activate, it's telling the next one, it's like, if I'm filled and I do have a next one, if the next one is a null, tell the next one to fill up, right? So it's like one fills up, one tells two to fill up, two fills up, two tells three to fill up, three fills up, so on and so forth. Request deactivate, if one is filled, one tells two to unfill. No, right? If it's filled, then if is filled, if it's filled up, when the hell do I fill? Oh, what the fuck? Wait a minute, what the fuck? Oh, God damn it, this is so fucked up. Okay, so this is what's happening. It's like this, right? Because then it gets to the guy that is doesn't have. Okay, now I understand. Okay, so this is what's happening. Okay, so when it activates, it's simple, right? So the button tells. So let's say we have the button and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 connected. Oh man, we got those traditional gotta watch alone. Those are I've had it for years. You got my yours in Italy, moka pots. Oh, this one. Yeah. That's pretty cool. You have to buy different beans, right, for espresso. Like I can't just use I have to buy espresso beans and not coffee beans. Okay, so see this is what's happening. All right, this is what's going on here. When I so I've got the button and it's connected to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to the door. Right? So what happens is when the button lights up, it tells one to light up, which tells two to light up. Right, because then it fills up, and then it tells the next one to fill up. Yeah, because if it's not filled, it does the internal activate. Right, I get that. So it's like one tells two to fill, two tells three to fill, three fills tells four to fill, four fills tile five to fill, so on. The deactivate's a bit tricky because what it does is it, so they're all filled, right? So what it does is it tells the next one to request to deactivate, but it doesn't unfill right away. Two, so one tells two deactivate. If you don't have a next one, so it passes down the chain of command until it gets to six, which no longer has a one, and then it gets to there, right? Because this one has no longer not an X, a next one, and then it calls internal deactivate, which then unfills. So then it unfills backwards. So that's what's happening. It's like it fills backwards. I don't fucking know why it does that. Oh shit. Espresso roast is usually a very dark roast, which I avoid because it plugs out my machine. The dark, oily grind sticks together and act like cement, and water won't go through. Wow, this one's really intense. It's good. Wow. Stumptown coffee roaster, and I got the house blend. Chocolate, red fruit, composed. It's very good. Okay, so Yeah, so I'm gonna have to actually. This is gonna be a lot more fucking work than I imagined. It's just tricky. So shouldn't it? It is on the internal deactivate. Oh, you know what it should be? It should request deactivate. Hey, your feature at E3. Sorry. That's basically what E3 is like, a huge game event, right? That's like the biggest game convention for press in LA. And I got a spot to show Manifold Garden there, which is really, really awesome. But we just found that out yesterday. Yeah, okay, let's try this out, and then I'm gonna take a break. I think that's enough stream today. I think I just need to like sit down and work on this a bunch more. Hopefully try to get it done tonight. I kind of want to start working on this. That's what that was yesterday. Yeah, we actually got a call right before it got started. Hey, insert me here. Thank you. Welcome. Through Sony. I did not apply to IndieCade. I don't even know if I'm gonna apply to IndieCade. It's so expensive. Hey, CP Da Beast. Thank you for the follow. Yeah, through Sony. I was actually just talking earlier about I don't even know if I wanna. Oh, fuck yes! Hey guys, did you see that? I fucking. Okay, of course it's doing the problem now where it's like light. It's deactivating too many things, but so you can see what's how much it's a lot. It's like 150. I don't know, maybe I'm just like I've just gotten spoiled working with Sony now, but like, so with IndieCade it's 150. I don't know if I'm gonna get in. If I do show, I gotta like, they don't provide hotel, I gotta get flight tickets, I gotta set up, and whereas like with, and the, so, the showing at E3, there's like the IndieCade area, and it's cool, but it's like super small and tiny, and they got things running on laptops, Or it's like you show with Sony and you're in the Sony area, like, you know, people, like, it's Sony, right? It's PlayStation 4. And I mean, I think Indiecade is really cool. It's just like that process is very mysterious to me. And, you know, Sony covers, they don't cover flight, but they cover hotel. Like, it's just really great. And they set up, they provide all the setup for you and everything. I don't know, just that it's a lot of effort to apply. So it's just turning off too much now. It's like it's turning off all of them. It's just a lot of effort to apply. And then, yeah, it's a lot of effort and a lot of work to apply, and you pay money and there's no for a chance to show, and then once you get in, it's still like there's you still have a lot of stuff to do. Hey, Dark App, so we are actually just about to end the stream. I think I know what the issue is. It's like it needs to, the when it cuts off, it's like this actually needs to get killed first. Yeah, if you're in LA, then it's fine, right? So you should definitely apply for it. Yeah, I don't know. Just conventions are so expensive, and I don't know why people don't focus on streaming a lot more. I think it's actually just like a much better platform than standing, paying thousands of dollars and flying out so I can talk to people for like 10 minutes at a time, whereas here I can really just kind of share a lot of the stuff that I think is more interesting. Hey, King Dragon 2713. Thank you for the follow. All right, I think we almost got it. Like the logic is still very, very messy. Fuck. I don't know why it's turning off. Before it wasn't turning off, now it's turning off too much. So why is this one getting turned off? I think it's because of, I know what's happening. Right, so you can set up your own schedule. It's not archived. I can do it for as long as I want. Yeah, and it's just so insanely expensive. I don't know. I think when I read the Gary Newman article about marketing, and it's like you go to PAX East and it's exhausting. You're there like 8 hours a day. You have to wake up super early to get there. There's a ton of traffic. If you're one person, it's like hard to find time for lunch, and you lose your voice because you're talking to people all day. And like, if I talk to six people in an hour, that's six people an hour, 8 hours a day, that's six times eight, what, 48? So 50 people over the course of the day. I'm talking to 50 people right now. I'm talking to 57 people. And I'm not like super rushed or anything. And if people have questions, I can just show them what the game is doing. And you know, I'm not really taking time away from development. I am working on development. I don't know why. Why is this getting unset? I think it has to do with the sort of the next prev thing. Ah, God, this delegate is such a pain. How much do I find streaming to interfere with it? And I can do it all while sipping coffee. That is great. It's good. I mean, I don't find it a huge thing. We got a ton of work done today. I'm just the thing is, programming is not my strong point, but this forces me to focus, and I'm trying to talk through what, like, for me, it's very helpful to kind of talk through what's going on here, right? Because so it seems like what we're doing is, what we are doing is, aha. Think this is it. Think this is it. Okay, I think we've got it. Let's try this, and we will go. I think maybe if Sean is still streaming, we should go raid him again. Okay, so I think that's good. Let's take a screenshot here. Yeah, it's just I got this. Now I know why people complain about delegates actually being really hard to debug. Oh, fuck. Okay. I just need a break. I'm gonna go outside for a walk. But first, let's see if Sean is still streaming. And yes, we'll raid Sean. Damn, yeah, so Sean is another developer working on Even the Ocean, just started streaming, so cool to show him some support. Hey, happy Yappy. Thank you for the follow. Hey, Sean's got the same gloves as I do. He copied me, by the way. I was the one that suggested getting the black ones, the blue ones. So, anyway, thanks guys for stopping by. We got this line almost there, figured out what's happening. I want to finish it tonight, and then tomorrow we will be back to hopefully more level design. I want to get this done so I can do more level design. But anyway, huge thanks for stopping by, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Have a good rest of your Thursday.